It's the hands I'll always remember. The hands that cradled and sheltered a baby boy thrust suddenly into a great big frightening world. I remember in the middle of the night, all sorts of shadows would be reaching at me from out of the closet. And sometimes when a very bad dream would just terrify this little guy, it was those hands that never failed to reach for me at my bedside. Reassuring, calming the storm inside of me. When my hands would often get me in trouble, again I felt her hands, strong, but no less loving. When patience had been exhausted, those hands spoke the only language I would understand. Not always welcome, but needed, just the same. I knew Mom loved me because, as often as she told me, even more often she showed me. In time, those hands no longer reached down, but up. Still always reaching to help, to love. Tapping my shoulders when I didn't stand as tall and as straight as a mother's son should. Those hands that stroked my forehead when I lay burning with fever. She was quick to point a finger at me when she knew I was in the wrong, but even quicker to reach out to silence anyone else who didn't properly understand her boy. Later, I would wonder at those hands that could make almost any food taste like something special. They cleaned and scrubbed, picked up after me far too many times. Now, there are things in this world, quite frankly, that seem scarier than things that used to come out of my closet in the middle of the night. And I'd be lying if I said there aren't times I really miss the comfort of those wonderful hands. It's then that I remember the greatest gift she gave me was with her hands. Those hands, reminding me of another's hands sacrificed for me. And I realize all she ever did for me was with one goal in mind. To take my hands and leave them lovingly in his hands.